question on releasing the Spirit. Is the Holy Spirit also in my flesh all the time? Let's put it this way. If you stand next to a fire, the heat from the fire will warm up your flesh. So the fire is not in your flesh, but the heat from the fire will warm your flesh. So the Holy Spirit being in your spirit, okay, doesn't mean he's always in your flesh, but the life emanating from the Spirit is in your flesh. Hopefully that, you know, answers the question. Now, you can release the power of the Spirit. When we talk about releasing the Spirit into your flesh, that's probably not the most perfect, most accurate word to use or way of saying it. But technically, what you're doing is you are releasing the power of the Spirit into your flesh to make alive, right? And so what you're doing is you are directing it. Now, there are people that said, I want to try to do this. You know, I've read your book, and I want to know how to do this, but I'm not able to release the Spirit into my flesh. Okay. I don't know how you're judging that. Okay. I don't know how you're deciding you're not doing it, unless, of course, you're just maybe not getting well or something. Maybe that's the question. But the answer here is this. The same way you got saved is the same way you do everything in the kingdom. You do it all by faith. And faith, here's an aspect that a lot of people don't realize. A major aspect of faith is a decision. If you go to Hebrews 11, it says that Moses chose, right? So faith is a decision. Making a decision is an aspect of faith. If you have not made a decision, you are technically not truly walking in faith yet, because faith is a decision. Now, when you heard the gospel, heard that God wanted to save you, heard that he paid Jesus' life to save you, at some point you might have heard it, you might have thought it was a great idea, but if you don't make the decision to believe it and to make Jesus Lord, then you're not born again. So before you do anything, you know, I had the people in the church a while back tell me, okay, think about standing up. Don't stand up, but think about it. Think about it. Now, want to. And I said, but now notice, as you want to, you're still not standing up. You're not going to stand up until you make a decision to stand. So you can know about it, you can think about it, you can want it, but until you make a decision, you're not going to have it. So it's the same thing. You can know everything about faith. You can know everything about releasing the Spirit, the power of the Spirit, into your flesh. You can know about it. You can think about it. You can want it. But until you make the decision, I'm going to do it, it won't happen. Now, the minute you truly make the decision to release the Spirit or the power of the Spirit into your flesh, it happens. Why? Because you've made a decision, and by faith, you choose to do it. So the minute you do that, it happens. The power of the Spirit is released into your flesh to drive out sickness and disease wherever there is sickness or disease. So it's a choice. It's a decision. You make the choice, you make the decision, and you decide, now, right now, I'm going to do it. Just like you did get born again. See, you had to act in faith. You had to make that decision. And it's the same thing once you're in the kingdom. How you got in the kingdom is how you function in the kingdom. So it's real simple. You have to decide to release, and then you decide and you trust and you have faith that you have released the Spirit. Now, you can also do it. You can release it and leave it on to where it's constant, right? Now, that will work, and it's how I tend to live, but at the same time, you can also get distracted and cause that to back off. So when you get distracted, how do you get distracted? Well, when you start hearing constantly, this sickness, that sickness, this thing coming around, this is going to get you, get your flu shot, get your whatever other shot, you know, they got a shot for everything now, whatever it is. And if you surround yourself with that, then your faith is going to start retreating. And when it starts to retreat, then you're going to catch yourself backing off. So you have to be very aggressive. Why? Because the world is aggressive. See, the world is passive aggressive. It will be aggressive, and when you don't agree with it, they will shun you or they will talk about you or something else. That's passive aggressive. And so that's how the world deals with you. It keeps pressing. That's why it says in Romans, don't be conformed to this world. Why? Because the world is always pressuring you to be conformed to it. And the only way you won't be conformed is to have your mind renewed to the Word of God so that your life will be transformed and not conformed.